Let's get some practice counting money. So I have 6 coins right over here. And these are all United States coins, so we're counting money in the United States for these examples. And what is this first coin? Well, this is called a quarter or a quarter dollar. So it represents 25 cents. And we could write it out as 25 cents, but I'll just write it as 20. Well, I'll just keep that one like that. Now this one's another quarter, so it is also going to be 25 cents. Now this one looks different, but it's just the other side of this coin, of these coins. This is what the other side looks like. So this is also going to be 25 cents. These are 3 quarters right over here. So how much money do these 3 quarters represent? Well, it's going to be 25 plus 25, which is 50, plus 25, which is going to be 75. So these 3 quarters are going to be 75 cents. And remember, 100 cents make a dollar. So this is still less than $1. But we're not done yet. We have this nickel. This is a nickel right over here. That represents 5 cents. And then we have another nickel here. It looks different, but it's just the other side. This is the head side. This is the tail side. So this is also another 5 cents. And so these 2 nickels, if you add them together, they are going to represent 10 cents. And then finally, you have a penny, and it even says it right over here, is 1 cent. In fact, they all say it here. This is 5 cents. This is 1 cent. So this right over here is going to be 1 cent. So what is 75 plus 10 plus 1? Well, 75 plus 10 is 85, plus 1 is 86. So this is equal to 86 cents. And if it felt a little bit too fast to count up 25, 50, 75 in your head, you could also add them up. 25, 25, 25, plus 5, plus 5, and another 5, plus 1, plus 1. You could add them up this way, and then what would you get? 5 plus 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 5 is 20, plus 5 is 25, plus 1 is 26. So that's 2 tens and 1 6. Put the 2 tens up here. 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8. So you could get 86 cents either way. Let's do one that has even more coins in it. So here we go. We have, so what is it? What's going on here? This right over here is a quarter. That's going to be 25 cents. 25 cents. And then we have one that we didn't see in the previous example. We have 2 dimes. A dime represents 10 cents. So we have 2 dimes, or we could have those each represent 10 cents. Then we have 2 nickels. We've already seen those each represent 5 cents. So 5 and 5. And then we have 4 pennies. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we could put each penny separately like that. Or we could say, look, 4 pennies, each of them represent 1 cent. So that's going to be 4 cents. So let me do it that way. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, that's going to be 4 cents. And then we could just add everything up. So 5 plus 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 4 is 19. 19 is 1 10 and 9 1, so I can put the 1 10 in the tens place. 1 plus 2 is 3. Plus 1 is 4, plus 1 is 5. So it's 5 tens, 5 tens and 9 ones. So 59 cents. This right over here is 59 cents. And notice, we have more coins, but it represents less value than the previous example. That's because we had a lot of coins that didn't represent a lot of values. Like we had these 4 pennies here. Well, in the previous example, we had 3 quarters. Quarters represent, each of these quarters is equivalent to 25 pennies. So we're able to represent more money with fewer coins in the first example.